Jerusalem now enjoyed centuries of relative prosperity and stability. However, in the 4th century BC, Macedonia became the dominant power in the region. Alexander the Great defeated the Persians in 331 BC in Syria, and Jerusalem became the capital of the ancient Greek province of Judea. Throughout his life, Alexander was renowned for his tolerance towards conquered peoples. The people of Jerusalem were no exception. Under Greek domination, Jerusalem became an important trading center. Many of its Jewish inhabitants, however, sought commercial opportunities elsewhere, such as at Alexandria in Egypt.
We're going to now discuss the Hellenistic period. This is time where the Greek culture has a great influence over the land of Palestine, over the land of Israel, through the conquest of one general called Alexander the Great, who conquered most of the ancient world throughout Egypt and the land of Israel, the land of the Mesopotamians, and even further east. It's just amazing. But what happened was, is with these conquests, he brought in his culture. Alexander liked to keep the culture that was best reflective of those people that he conquered. So they weren't wiped out. He liked to keep that colorful part of their culture, but also he added with that culture of the region, his Greek culture. So the Greek language became the language of trade, the language of what was well known. Okay. Also their art and their design, such as their pottery design, pottery such as terracotta. Once again, why is it so important? Because archaeologists look at terracotta to determine what time period that we're going to be in.